In this video, we will see how to encrypt, decrypt, and verify a message using asymmetric encryption, with code example in JavaScript, Python, and Java. But let's first see the difference between symmetric and asymmetric encryption. In symmetric encryption, you have a single key that is used to encrypt and decrypt the data. The main problem here is how to securely share the key between the sender and the recipient, since anyone that has the key can encrypt and decrypt messages. Asymmetric encryption uses two keys, a public key that can be openly shared and a private key that must be kept a secret. We will see later the exact flow and operation, but the idea is that when someone wants to send a secure message, they use the recipient public key to encrypt it. The encrypted message can only be decrypted by the recipient that has the private key. Asymmetric encryption also enables digital signatures, where the sender can use his private key to sign a message, and anyone that has the sender public key can verify the authenticity. Having two separate keys allows secure communication, authentication, and integrity. But let's dive into the code. Let's start with key generation. The process involves creating a pair of keys. The keys are mathematically linked, but computationally difficult to derive one from another. The private key is generated first, and then the corresponding public key is derived from it. Once the keys are generated, the public key can be distributed to others. But it is not as easy as it seems. It's important to ensure the integrity and authenticity of the public key during distribution, to prevent tampering and impersonation. For now, let's say that using a secure channel like SSH or TLS is enough. But let's see some code. We will use RSA for all the examples, but switching to elliptic curve will be straightforward, since the API is the same. Let's start from Python, just because the API reflects better what we said before. We will be using the cryptography model, since there is nothing in the standard library. We start by creating a private key. From the private key, we derive the public key. At this point, we can convert the public key using an export format to share it with others. There are various formats, so you should be aware of what is supported by the various libraries you want to use. You can also convert the private key in a standard format to be able to read it from different languages. Remember that the private key must be kept private. JavaScript has a standard crypto modules, and more or less the code is similar to what we've seen. Here, we are using the generate key method from the crypto module, and we have to specify a lot more information about the algorithm we want to use and the operation that we'll be using, like encrypt decrypt. The result will be an object containing the private key and the public key. To convert the key in an exportable format, there is an export key method that takes the format and the key and will give back an array buffer. Similarly, in Java, we create a key pair generator specifying the RSA algorithm. Then we generate the key pair. If we want to convert the key to an exportable format, we take the RSA key factory instance and get the specific format encoder. Those examples are basically the same and exports in the same format. Before trying to encrypt something, let's take a look at how to load a key. We can read exported keys from a file or somewhere else. Here, we use base64 strings of the exported keys. In Python, there are methods for the specific formats that will convert directly the bytes into a key object. In Java, more or less is the same thing. We have to get the key factory and use the encoder classes to get back the public or the private key object. In JavaScript, again, the import key method wants a lot of more information other than the format, like the algorithm that we are going to use and the operation that we are going to perform with that key. Finally, let's see the methods to encrypt and decrypt the data. We have to specify the algorithm we're going to use. In this case is RSA-OAEP. There are various padding schemes. Again, if you want to interact with different languages, you have to pick the one supported by all of them. And finally, by using the public key, we can encrypt the message and get back the ciphertext. On the other side, with the private key, we can decrypt the message. In Java, we define the padding parameters, we create a cipher instance in encrypt mode with the algorithm parameters and the public key, and then we encrypt the message. Same thing for decryption. We create the cipher instance in decrypt mode using the private key and decrypt the ciphertext. In JavaScript, we have specified most of the parameters in the key generation or the key loading step. So here, we just use the encrypt and decrypt method with some minimal information. Everything looks easy. Unfortunately, there is one thing that we overlooked. The maximum message length that we can encrypt with asymmetric encryption algorithm is limited and proportional to the key size. For example, with an RSA key of 2K, we can encrypt only around 245 bytes, and with a key of 4K, we are around 500 bytes. A larger key size leads to slower encryption and decryption operation due to the intensive mathematical computation required, so encrypting large messages directly with asymmetric encryption can be impractical. To overcome this limitation, hybrid encryption is commonly employed. To solve the problem, we can use symmetric and asymmetric encryption together. We will use AES as the symmetric encryption algorithm. The first step is to create the AES key, For each message, we generate a new key, then encrypt the data with that key. To solve the problem of sending the symmetric key, we use asymmetric encryption, and we encrypt the AES key with the public key of the recipient. Then we deliver both the encrypted key and the encrypted message to the recipient. Only the recipient can decrypt the AES key, and only with that key the message can be decrypted. Let's see the code to generate the key. For the examples, we will be using AES 256 keys. In Python, there are no helper functions, and we can just generate 32 bytes of secure random data. In Java, we get an instance of the AES key generator, specifying the size, and then we generate the key. To get the raw bytes, we can use the getEncoded method. On the other side, we take the raw bytes and create the secret key specifying AES as the algorithm. In JavaScript, using the crypto module, we have to specify upfront all the parameters and all the operation we are going to perform with that key. To get the raw bytes, we can use the import key and export key methods. AES can be used with different modes. We are going to use AES GCM for the examples. Here, the code will be a bit different depending on the mode. For example, GCM has an initialization vector as input and produces an authentication tag aside from encrypted data. In Python, we start generating an initialization vector, we use 12 bytes of secure random data. Then we initialize the cipher, specifying the AES key and the GCM mode with the initialization vector. From the cipher, we get the encryptor, and with that, we can call update to encrypt pieces of data, and once we are done, we can call finalize. And we have the AES encrypted data. At this point, we have to compose a block with the initialization vector, the encrypted data, and the authentication tag. When we want to decrypt this block of data, we have to split the three pieces. We generate a cipher specifying the AES key and the GCM mode with the initialization vector and the authentication tag. We get the decryptor and call update with the encrypted data. And we end with a finalized call. At this point, we will have the decrypted input message. In Java, we do the same thing. We create a AES GCM cipher in encryption mode with the GCM parameters, then we compose the block. In Java, the cipher will already append the authentication tag to the AES encrypted data, so we just need to prepend the initialization vector. For decryption, we have to split the initialization vector from the cipher block data. We initialize the cipher in decryption mode with the GCM parameters, and we decrypt the data block. At the end, we will add the decrypted input message. Again, in JavaScript, we do the same. We generate a secure random data for the initialization vector, we encrypt the message and concatenate the input vector and the cipher block. JavaScript already appends the authentication tag to the encrypted data. For decryption, we split the initialization vector from the encrypted data block and we call decrypt to get back the decrypted input message. Now that we have everything, we can stitch together the pieces. We generate an AES key, use that to encrypt the data using asymmetric encryption algorithm, then we use asymmetric encryption to encrypt the generated AES key and send everything over the network. Only the owner of the private key can decrypt the AES key and with that decrypt the message. Cool, but there is one more problem. What we did is to ensure that only the owner of the private key is able to decrypt the message, but anyone can send encrypted messages since the public key is public. So, how can we verify the authenticity of the sender? To do that, we can leverage digital signatures. Using the private key of the sender, we can create a signature of the message and send it over with the key and encrypted data. On the other side, once we have decrypted the message, we can check if the signature matches by using the public key of the sender. By signing the plain text, any modification or tampering of the message content can be detected. From a code point of view, in Python, the private key is a method sign, where we specify the message to sign, the padding and the hash to use, which is basically the signature type. Again, there are multiple padding and hash that you can use. If you interact with multiple languages, you should check the one that's supported by all of them. To verify a signature, there is a verify method on the public key that takes the signature to check, the message to validate, and the algorithm parameters. An exception will be returned if the signature is not valid. In Java, we can get an instance of the signature object specifying the type of the signature. Then we specify the private key user for signing, we use the update method to pass the data to sign, and we compute the signature using the sign method. To verify a signature, we get an instance of the signature object, we initialize it with the public key, and we use the update method to pass the data we have signed, the non-encrypted data. Then we use the verify method, passing the signature we received, and get back a boolean that tells us if the signature is valid. JavaScript is a bit different, just because the key must be loaded specifying the signature algorithm. So we have to reload the key specifying the signature information, and then we can just use .sign and .verify method on the keys to generate and verify the signature. That's it. Now you can send and receive messages securely. The things to remember are Asymmetric encryption has two keys, a public key that can be publicly shared and is used by the sender to encrypt the message. This message can only be decrypted by the private key that should stay where generated. If you share it, then the system is no longer secure. The maximum length of the message that can be encrypted with asymmetric encryption is proportional to the key size, so it's small. For larger messages, we mix symmetric and asymmetric encryption. A new symmetric key is generated for every message. The message is encrypted using the symmetric encryption, then asymmetric encryption is used to encrypt the key. And if we also want to verify the authenticity of the sender can sign the message using its private key. The receiver can decrypt the symmetric key with its private key, decode the message with the decrypted key, and verify the signature using the public key of the sender. And that's about it. You can check out the description below for the link to the source code. And if you have any question or want to know more, leave a comment below.